Moleni kuninonke emakhaya, igama lam nguSibabalwe Mrhwebi, and I'm your host for this afternoon, Nibukele Uzwelitsha TV, and I'm sure you can tell, ikhona into eyenzekayo that's different from what you know, and the reason for why that is because siniphathele into that we've not ever brought you before. Siniphathele a contestant of Miss South Africa 2021, who is also a local, olapha eQonce, and she's here to have a chat with us namhlanje, an incredible young lady, igama lakhe nguZimi Mabunzi. Okay, so the first thing we just want to find out is ukhulelephi. How did you grow up? What was your upbringing like?
This is always such a trick question. I was actually having to answer this question just the other day. Mm-hmm. And I always feel like it's a bit of a trick question because I grew up in a lot of places.
Okay.
I think my story tells of the story of many young black children all around the country and really mostly around the world, where, you know, Umdu is really raised by a village of people. Mm. So Umdu could identify me as Umdu waseXesi, omnye could identify me as Umdu waKwaSaki, omnye Dimbaza, omnye Qonce, njalo njalo, because I wasn't always, you know, in the perfect nuclear family setup. So I was really raised by a whole lot of people. So
love that.
Yeah.
Absolutely incredible. What would you say was your biggest achievement, ukhula?
My biggest achievement in the ukhula, doesn't have to be in the ukhula, or just
not
generally.
Not even ukhula, just generally.
I think right now, at the top of my mind, my biggest achievement would definitely have to be overcoming my mind. There's so many things, so many experiences that could have made me a hard person, a person that is, I don't know, bitter, or a person that's angry. So overcoming those things and getting to a point where I believe in myself so much that I'm able to place myself phambikwabantu and declare a dream this big, that is a testament to have overcoming my mind, to believing myself, and to just being a person that lives a life of courage. So yeah, that is my biggest achievement.
Oh, all right. So what would you say was your biggest failure?
That is a difficult one.
Yeah.
My biggest failure, I would not say maybe my biggest failure, maybe a failure that life dealt me, rather.
Okay.
I'd say it would be finally leaving home. I come from a small town, obviously, NgwaseQonce, very small, tight-knit town, and you obviously you look forward to venturing outside of your town. You look forward to living, you know, having this design, this life in your high school years. And so the first thing that happened to me after I had ventured outside of school, I had gone to university, started my first year in Cape Town, and I got financially excluded. You know, typical story, you know, for a child in this country. And that was basically my first introduction to, I don't know, to life. I always say that was like life just clapping me in the face to say, hey, this is what happens. This is how it goes down sometimes. And so that set me back a bit. I mean, from 19-year-old me at the time, that wasn't the most ideal thing to have happened to me. It wasn't the most amazing thing. I think I was not mature enough maybe at the time to understand, you know, the delays that life can sometimes give you,
understandably,
the detours that sometimes, you know, you're dealt with. So it set me back in terms of my plans, my visions that I envisioned for myself, and so on and so forth. So that has to have been the biggest failure. And bouncing back from that was definitely not easy, because, I mean, as a young child, you're watching your friends advancing and progressing and moving, and you're just, you know, you have to go back home and sort of go back to the drawing board and find, you know, ways to be innovative about your life.
How did you get out of that? How did you overcome that space?
First of all, my faith. I really made sure that I centered myself and I fully immersed myself in what I believed in, which is God.
Love.
Through. Secondly, I also just managed to, because of the people that are surrounded me, fortunately enough, I had people that were ready to support me, people that had opened their arms to me and were just like, you know what, we're going to be here to support you no matter what. I immersed myself in izinto that I was passionate about. You know, I was involved in the community. I was involved in outreaches at church. I immersed myself fully in church as well. And I sort of started finding myself in that particular space, finding what I could do more with my time, because I obviously had a a lot of free time.
I had a lot of time on my hands all of a sudden.
But what I knew was that I was not going to just chill. Yeah. So that's pretty much how I got out of it. You know, more things started happening from just me fully immersing in myself in the things that I love to do, which is living a life of impact. I immersed myself in the things that advance the girl child because I knew that's what I would have wanted, you know, to have been done for me. I immersed myself in Izinto that just really made me happy and made me such a joyful person. So that's how I made it out of that.
Love it, because Negasi make it out of every single situation. Second last one. What inspires you?
What inspires me? I'd say maybe my upbringing. I think of my background and I draw a lot of inspiration and a lot of strength from it. I don't come from the most glamorous background. My family structure or the nature or, you know, of my family as life wasn't the most glamorous. It wasn't the most normal for a child. So I draw a lot of inspiration from that. When I think about, you know, how it took so much. It took so much pain and sort of so much discomfort for me to have been this person that I am today. And when I think of that, I think I can only do better. I can only go forward. There's no other way. I need to make sure that the next person that probably goes what I've gone through, you know, sees an example, you know, sees a way through when they see me, and they don't see, no hope. Yeah. So living a life of hope for others is what inspires me.
Absolutely love it. What type of legacy do you want to leave behind?
I want to be known for being a woman that inspires a life of courage.
Good.
I want to be known as a woman that goes regardless of your background, goes regardless of what you've been through, your experiences. I just want to be known for being a young woman that left a trail for others to follow. I believe in being an informed young woman, being an empowered young woman, being a knowledgeable young woman. I've seen the protection and sort of the sustenance that it's afforded me to be an informed young woman, to be a positive role model, and, you know, live a life that is just empowered. So I want to also afford that for other young women, you know, to say that there is, you know, a road sort of less traveled that gets you, you know, exactly where you want to be. And so I just want to leave behind, you know, a trail of young women that believe in themselves, that courageously go in the direction of their dreams, no matter what, no matter what they've seen, no matter what they have not seen, you know, to just create the life that you desire, no matter what.
No matter what. Yeah. Absolutely love that. Nizvele nani betunana. I'm pretty sure I combed after this that would not want you to be Miss South Africa. It's absolutely inspiring hearing you. Yeah, I want you to be Miss South Africa. Now I'm just like, So the thing that's happening now, you said a little bit earlier on, was that you're moving from the top 30. Congratulations, first of all. Congratulations. You're moving from the top 30 and we're trying to get you into the top 10. How do people get you into the top 10?
All right. So we do this by voting. There are two methods that we've been given by the organization to get, you know, your top 30 into the top 10.
Perhaps you could speak directly to them and tell them.
Okay. So hello, everybody. Dinguzimi ngona phakade mabunzi. I am in your Miss South Africa top 30 and I need your help to get into the top 10 of Miss South Africa. So you can do this by voting for me. There are two methods that you can use to vote for me. One, you can go directly to a CompuTicket, any CompuTicket outlet all around the country. You just simply go there, ubaxelele that you would like to go vote for a top 30 Miss South Africa finalist, and that top 30 Miss South Africa finalist is Uzimi Mabunzi. My number is 30. My number is 30. You don't have to it's really easy to remember because there's 30 of us and I'm the last one. So number 30, Zimi Mabunzi at CompuTicket. The second way is that you just find me on social media. My link is pretty much everywhere. I share it every single day, almost every single hour of the day. So you can just find my link. And okanye, if you have not found my link, you go directly to the Miss South Africa website and you find the voting Koninda Wapaina with the voting instructions and so on. You find my face. You don't even have to find my name. You click on my face and there you go. You vote using the link and it will need your card details and so on and so forth. But the instructions are pretty much simple to follow.
So you go to CompuTicket. You go on her social media. Ukangela uZimi Mabunzi. Go CompuTicket and ukangela uZimi Mabunzi as well on social media. Follow each of the links that are on her social media platforms. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. So that sibe nekeli yethu in the winning spot for Miss South Africa. Thank you so much for coming. Siyabulela kakhulu for granting us the privilege and the honor to have you apha kuzwelitsha TV before uthathe the world stages. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you so much to you as well, Ekhaya, for tuning in. It is always, always awesome having you. Maybe I'll be back. We'll have a look and a chat with the people behind the scenes. Simone, it was my pleasure being here. We'll see you a little bit later on. Goodbye.